Thank you. So the next piece is by Walter Buller-Marx. He is a brother of the most famous landscape artist in Brazil. They have a property in Guaratiba, Rio de Janeiro, which is where it's the title from that piece is from. Now it's a museum to celebrate Roberto Buller-Marx's works as a landscape artist. It's in five movement suite, and something that's interesting in that suite is he doesn't call them like first movement, second movement. He calls first violero is a name for guitarist or a general name for anybody that plays a plucked string instrument. So it seems as if this would be, each movement would be a different person playing, which I think, considering how contrasting the movements are, makes sense in that piece. So it's five movements, and it's written on the program, each one of them. So, the suite Violeiros de Guaratiba by Walter Buller-Marx. Thank you.
Thank you.
So the next piece is a sonata in three movement by César Guerra-Peixe. Guerra-Peixe is a very relevant and unique composer in Brazil. In the early 40s, he was one of the leaders of a movement that wanted to introduce in Brazil German avant-garde composition techniques. So it's more serialism, dodecaphonism, this kind of techniques. And a decade later, he was a leader of another movement called the Armorial Movement, which wanted to create a Brazilian classical art form with the least influence of European culture. So he was at the same time a leader in two contrasting movements. His music is heavily influenced by the music of Pernambuco, which is from Brazil, but a different kind of Brazilian music. And this is what you're going to listen in this sonata. It's a three movement piece, an allegro, a larghetto, followed by a vivacissimo. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks for those who are watching the live stream or the recording. I'll finish with a piece, a commissioned work. Part of my research here is commissioned works by composers born where I'm from in Brazil, which is Brasília. And in that area, we have a folk instrument very similar to the guitar. Has a very strong folk and idiomatic tradition, and it's so strong and it's so idiomatic that I've asked composers to write a piece for guitar using any of those resources, and everybody that I've contacted for quite some time said that it was impossible. Then I met this guy from Texas, Joel Hobbs, and he didn't know that it was impossible, so he did it. So at the third section at the piece, you're going to notice some rasgueados and some effects that are typical from that instrument, which is the viola caipira. The piece is inspired by a poem. Joel researched a lot of this folk music, and in his research, he listened to a song about a mythical instrument, a mythical viola, as red as earth dust, that made its owner play better. He makes no reference to the song itself, but the lyrics and that myth around, somehow touched him, and he decided to call the piece "Of Earth's Dust."
Thank you.
to play as an encore something totally different from the program, and that is the case. So I believe you're going to recognize that one.